Connie and Fish.
Welcome to a brand new version of Stay's Ghost Stories. Now with more old timey.
Did somebody say old timey?
Yes, yes I did. I said old timey. Ah, there we are.
Those of you just now tuning in, tonight's subject is...
The Legend of the Ada Witch. The story begins over 150 years ago. And now to your host, please welcome Stephen Bonner.
First, I want to tell you the tale of the Ada Witch. And to do that, I want to introduce you to a brand new helper for the month of October, Vampire Steve.
Good evening.
It's morning, Vampire Steve.
Oh, good morning. Sorry, I can't tell. I'm in my coffin.
It's okay. So what's the legend of the Ada Witch?
I bet it sure is an old-timey tale.
Did somebody say old-timey?
I did.
Okay, stop talking amongst each other, Vampire Steve and old-timey Steve.
Did somebody say?
Shh. Vampire Steve, get to the legend.
Right. In the late 1800s, a man suspected his wife of having an affair. So he followed her one night when she thought he would be asleep. Sure enough, she went into a field near their property, where she met her lover. The husband was enraged, and he killed the wife, which resulted in a struggle with the other man. Both men died as a result of their injuries. It is said that late at night, especially during the night of and the night preceding a full moon, people driving by this field have seen her ghost wandering the land, searching for her lover. Some people have revolted, stopping to try to communicate with her, but she always disappears or runs into the nearby woods, where she cannot be followed due to thick brambles that inhabit that area. She is said to be dressed in a long white gown, which authorities say date back to the turn of the century. Usually she's seen alone, but other witnesses report seeing a ghostly death scene reenacted. Others report seeing nothing but hearing the killer's shouts of rage.
Dang, that makes me angry.
Followed by the victim's screams of agony.
Ah!
Although it is said that she haunts the field on Honey Creek Road, where she died, other witnesses have reported seeing her nearby Seedman Park and the nearby Findlay Cemetery. Ooh, just got a little French there. There she is supposedly buried. Sometimes you can see a misty blue figure floating within a 3-mile radius of the Ada Cemetery and 2 miles between Egypt Valley and Honey Creek.
Thanks, Vampire Steve. Gotta work on that accent, bro. That was an excerpt of Ghosts of Grand Rapids by Nicole Bray and Robert Duchesne. The legend originated in the late 1800s and has become an urban legend in West Michigan.
But is any of it true?
That's a good question. It seemed that the witch was identified to be a woman named Sarah McMillan, at least according to a paranormals group research back in 2003. But this turned out to be a false identification, and even though McMillan wasn't the woman from the legend, her tombstone was completely destroyed between the years of 2003 and 2005 by ghost hunters and vandals breaking out pieces to sell online or for personal keepsakes.
Oh no!
Oh no!
Oh yeah!
It's a sad story because McMillan was completely innocent. In fact, it appears the Ada Witch never even actually existed. After poring through records, paranormal researchers were unable to find any death records that matched the killings in the legend, and they searched between the years of 1850 and 1950.
That's not true.
No, it's probably not true. But that doesn't mean the cemetery in question isn't haunted. There have been dozens of sightings over the years around the Findlay Cemetery. So I guess what it really comes down to is whether or not you believe in ghosts and are willing to take a stroll down 2 Mile Road during a full moon.
That sounds too spooky for me.
Me too, buddy.
Well, that settles it then. I guess we're all just too scared.
That really explained a lot, Bass, Dave. Good job.
Well, thank you, me, in some old-timey voice.
Did you just say old-timey?
Yeah, I did.
Well, that's the business. And just because I know there's some people out there who really love this song, I'm gonna have to play it one time.
That was Steve Stories. That was Steve Stories. That's Steve.
Connie and Fish.